The only series, Clarice, you play Catherine Martin, who is a character that we obviously know originated in Silence of the Lambs. This is such an iconic film and an even more iconic character. What was it like to play a new version of such a well-known character? What was your process like?
First of all, just overall excitement because I love Brooke Smith, love Silence of the Lambs. It's a huge honor to be trusted with this role, first and foremost. But I think what I love most about Catherine Martin as a character is how just unapologetic she is. She is totally herself, totally confident, certainly is not a wallflower. She is out there, and I think that's what honestly saved her in a lot of ways. So I was ecstatic that we get to expand her story.
Absolutely. Tell me a little bit about Catherine in the new series. How is her character different from the original film?
I would actually argue that she's not different, only that she's obviously been hugely traumatically affected. She is doing her best despite what has happened to her. And we're coming into the series a year after the events of the film. So she's kind of, in a way, the internal side of what Clarice is going through. While Clarice is high functioning and back in her field and doing her thing, Catherine's really in the trauma and in the quite literal effects of it. So I really appreciate that we're going into that kind of mental health headspace of it all, and that we're really taking that apart and witnessing it more than anything else.
What was your process like in kind of preparing to play a role with that kind of trauma? How did you go about that?
I always try to connect with my characters on some level, even if our symptoms or our life experiences are not the same. I will work my way down to really find where we overlap and where I resonate with her. For some reason, I felt hugely connected to Catherine. The more I read the book again and again, the more I read how Thomas Harris writes her, how Clarice observes her. I really fell in love with her. I think she's remarkable. I'm so impressed that she is really just fighting tooth and nail for her life and to get it back and really take charge.
You do a really beautiful job of showing that. A huge element in this series is kind of how Clarice finds herself while working in a very male-dominated field and how she kind of navigates that. What do you want viewers to take away from this, and also how she navigates it and what her messages are?
I think it's amazing that we get to address these topics, and I love that we have this perspective that truly did originate in the film, and we're continuing that on into her jumping into this workforce, her maybe not feeling ready or at least doubting it to some degree, and being concerned about being this kind of one-hit wonder of did she save Catherine Martin and was it a fluke, or does she really have this gift that she understands the behavioral sciences, not only just on the academic level, but in her heart and in her own mind. So I think it's a lot about trusting yourself and really going against the odds. I hope that viewers take away from it that they are capable of this. They're capable of really connecting to the thing that drives them and to do it anyway, no matter how many people tell them otherwise. I can identify with that. I know Rebecca Breeds, who plays Clarice, has spoken to identifying with that. So I really hope that what people take away from it is not only how to treat people that have dreams and are going for them, but to also do it for yourself if you have these big goals, sights, and ambitions.
The series deals with a lot of really delicate material, a lot of traumatic events. What did you find most difficult about this project?
I think just knowing that we have to treat it with such care and diligence. I know that if anybody's up to it, this group of people, creators, both on the crew, the producers, the writers, the actors, we care about it immensely. We know it's important. We're not making this show just to make TV, we're making it to say something. So I think each of us really have that kind of protective element to it. We want to see this make a difference in a way. So I think because we're dealing with really sensitive issues, we have an incredibly diverse and dedicated writers' room that I know is going to take just extreme care. It's already been evident in the episodes we've shot thus far. I'm excited. It's a little daunting, and of course it's going to be scary because we're not playing it safe. But I think I totally trust them with this process. I know that it's an open discussion in the workplace as well. I know if we have questions on a script, we're allowed to talk about those things with each other. There's no closed book. Yeah.
I really love that answer. That's a really interesting viewpoint on it. You mentioned that you were a big fan of the film before this. How has working on Clarice changed your view of it?
Oof. Huge fan. I loved the cinematography of it. I loved what it said about women in general, really fighting for themselves. In terms of it changing my perspective on Clarice, I think it made her even more human to me, seeing these stories. I really loved the movie as a whole picture, but I have to admit that I wasn't as attached to Clarice as a person before. And now that I really get to really get inside her head and see what's going on, and that each of these characters have an internal life of their own and their own histories and their own things they're dealing with. We're not just saying, okay, they choose this or that. Here's how they got to this point. We're showing all these inner things that I feel like in regular TV, we might not get to experience that as much. So I feel like I have a lot more respect and connection and just feeling human alongside these people.
100%. What about this series are you most excited for viewers to see? Is there anything that really stands out to you?
Oh my gosh, I don't even know what to pick. I think just as someone who really loves like crime TV, I love that I don't know what's coming. I definitely feel like I'm the person that either reading a book or watching a show or watching a movie, I'm like, I know what happens next. This happens next. I'm guessing this, I'm guessing that, and I can't do that. I can't do it with this one. Even with my own character, I'm reading something and all of a sudden I'm like, oh my gosh, like I did not think that's where this was going. So I hope that people just regularly get surprised by it to the point that they have to tune in the next week because something new is going to come around the corner for them.
You guys nail that suspense element. That's one of my favorite parts about the series as well. It really, yeah, you kind of have that on the edge of your seat aspect of it, which I seriously love. Now, another thing I love is that in this series, we really get a nod to the women's side of the story, which we didn't really see in the original film or in any of the readaptations, both Catherine's and Clarice's. What do you want viewers to know about Catherine's side of the story as they watch?
I think without spoiling anything, I really want them to see just the authentic person. I think both that goes for Clarice and Catherine. I want them to feel like they're not getting some censored version or a sliver of the whole picture. They're getting the whole picture of the person. And that means seeing their ugly side too, in the sense of sometimes they might play to politics. Sometimes they might make a great decision that we wish we were making ourselves as humans. Like all of those things coincide in one human being. So I feel like I want people to recognize that Catherine's fallible. I want them to know that she's not perfect and she's really fighting and doing her best and trying to survive and trying to, I don't want to say control, she's trying to exist again. Yeah.
Absolutely. I think a lot of people can relate to that whole trying to exist again. So it's really nice to have representation there. I love that. What was your favorite thing about filming the series?
These people. We just felt so blessed to be able to work in general during this time, and to shoot in a pandemic is remarkable. We're so lucky that both CBS and MGM have taken us so seriously and have really worked so hard to keep us safe and healthy. So really blessed to just have a chance to do this at all. And because of the pandemic, we were pushed a lot later than we thought we were going to film. So we got to know everybody through Zoom ahead of time, which doesn't really get to happen that much with film and TV. That's more of like a theater thing, that you get to know your people sooner. So for this, we really get to know each other, and we all helped each other through a pandemic in a way. Like this was such a light at the end of the tunnel for us. So we hope that the material can be a light at the end of the tunnel for people too. But yeah, just being grateful for getting the chance to do this and hopefully tell some really important stories.
Absolutely. Speaking of which was my next question, what was it like to film in the pandemic? How was that experience different from any other filming experience?
Well, I feel like in normal life, you kind of get to have an outside life and then go to work. And we don't really get that. We kind of are on perma lockdown and we go to work and we go back into lockdown pretty much. So it definitely, not that we can still get stir crazy, just like everybody else in the pandemic. But we also have this outlet of being able to channel some of this stuff into the work. And to be honest, we've channeled it into our characters too. We've kind of had a bit of an ongoing joke that Catherine is living a pandemic in the show as well. So you'll see as we get into the episodes what I mean by that. But it's a challenge, but it's also a reminder of being able to have the chance to do this. Not everyone gets to work right now. And I understand that and have a lot of empathy for that. And I just don't want to take it for granted for a second.
Absolutely. Life imitates art. Silence of the Lambs. Clarice takes place 6 months after the events of Silence of the Lambs. What would you say has happened to Catherine during that time period? What's she going through?
It's actually about a year after. She has gone through a lot. We definitely get into it within the pilot episode. And I think she's just someone that has really taken a direct hit. It's not Clarice, who's able to go back to work. Catherine is in it, and she's not bouncing back right away, at least. So I think to really see the wear and tear on her is important. It's certainly not easy. It's not easy on her family, her mom, and to witness someone that you love going through something like this and not knowing how to help them. I think it's important that we get both sides. We see someone who's fending all of it off and trying to keep it at bay, which I think is more of Clarice. And Catherine is really kind of, she's letting it all happen and show it. So as much as she's not going outside and really living that full life yet, you're seeing her really work through the stages a little bit more. So I think it's important that we see a journey like that. And we're not just like, nope, throw your suit on, go to work, you're fine. We're seeing the reality.
That is so important. And I think a lot of people really need to see that, especially nowadays. Mm-hmm. Last but certainly not least, what's up next for you? What can we expect for you in the future?
Oh my goodness. I have no idea, which is kind of terrifying and exciting all at the same time. This has been a roller coaster. I hope we get to keep making this. I hope we're lucky enough to get a season 2. That would be incredible. But I think the beauty about having a career in as an actor is you really don't know what's coming. You got to roll with the punches. And I think we're all learning that too right now of like, we literally don't know what next month is going to bring with this pandemic and hopefully everyone getting vaccinated and healthy and just kind of slowly but surely putting the pieces back together across the board. So honestly, I'm taking the small wins. I'm healthy and I get to work on a job that I love. So whatever comes next, let's do it.
Yes, absolutely. That's so glad. I'm so glad to hear that. Marnie, thank you so much for joining me today. I really appreciate it. You do
thank
such
you.
A brilliant job portraying Catherine. I absolutely love the series.
Thank you.
Have an amazing rest of your day. Enjoy Toronto.
You too. All right. Thank you. Appreciate your time.